This is how I play it, so I kept younger on it. Like, I'm 60, really, because I'm 70. If I was, like, 77, then I'd say I'm old because I'm in my 80s already. But 70, I'm in my, you know, in the 60s. Right?
Sure.
That's how I see it. And all things that happened in life to me, the action and everything, was in the middle of the decade. All the action. I was born 1930, so that's lucky, by having the zero. So 1935, the Depression was over. Then 1940, the war. Then 1945, the war's over. Then 1950, you got the a television in Squaresville and all that stuff popping up. Then 55, you got the big revolution beats and all that coming. And then 60, you got your hippies and that, and the Beatles and whatnot. And then 65, you got the war, Viet Cong War, and terrible. And then you get a gist of the slowing down of the 70s, where they're getting out of the war. And the 80s was just back to old mighty prosperity, like Eisenhower's 50s. And you listen to Jay Leno and those people, it's all redundant bullshit. And now the year 2000, by the year 2005, we should damn well know where we're gonna be. And I knew it would end like that for me because I thought I'd live forever, but no, it's gonna come that the days are shortening. It's going. And the new generations will come. And who will be remembered? Miles Davis and people like that, they'll come back. All kinds of things will happen. There'll be a big spiritual revolution. There won't be any more despots. They'll wipe those fuckers out quick. If anybody's gonna fuck up, it's gonna be America. Because that would be unique, that America would be the only country that didn't fall. And all countries fell. So why can't America fall? If it doesn't, then I prophesy correctly that the second coming, if it's first for the Christians and second for the Jews, no, second for the Christians and first for the Jews, because they're waiting for Messiah. Well, that happened. Christopher Columbus, Christ, came over on the Santa Maria, was born on the Santa Maria, the boat's always with Freud, Regina, womb, right? And landed on America, which is the second coming. Because it wasn't long ago. Wasn't long ago. And Spain didn't know what to do with it. Spain fucked up. Sure they did. And then that little pipsqueak Hitler comes along to think he maybe gives it a last shot. He was no dummy, obviously, but a smart madman was foisted upon us. And so I doubt that kind of shit will be around. They'll catch him fast. That's what I see. But if not, how can there be peace and love and all that with people being black and religious wars still being there for the Irish, the Arabs, the religious wars. I don't know. They all got to be cleaned up and answered. And then what? What's the big answer to clean it up? Death. Though it doesn't bring sorrow to people anymore. So that people can deal with it. That the old, like the Bible says, will have their dreams and the young will have their visions. And it will be told through such. Because that's always been a factor. The prophet has always been around. Have you noticed in ancient times that in Italy and Greece, all the prophets were female? Whereas in Israel, it was male. Yeah, the Jews definitely did have it right. There was something went wrong there. Something went terribly wrong. They were the saving ones, the gatherers of the tribe. They were. And they broke up the family. That's why I wonder if Abraham was Suma, which is supposedly the oldest place on the planet, it was non-Semitic. The Cavian was never a Jew, but Abraham was no Jew until his son, Israel, Isaac, got there.
That's the one he was asked to sacrifice.
Yeah, there you go, and that was the big revelation. Finally, the Jews woke up. And no more blood. No more spilling of blood. That was over with.